Geoffrey, does IT matter today? Nicholas Carson 10 years ago wrote about everybody's got their SAP and CRM and it didn't really matter. But today, it really does seem like there is strategic value here. And also the applications. What's the future for applications? How do they fit into this?
By the way, the goal should be at any given time for IT to go from mattering to not mattering. What that would mean is that it has been completely assimilated into... What Nicholas was really saying was you can't differentiate with IT anymore because everybody has it. But so it just kind of raised the entire bar. Well, right now the bar is very unevenly raised. The digitally competent companies are eviscerating their competition. I mean, it's not a fair fight. And so part of the function of everybody in this room, I hope, and the whole B2B2C business model is B's from Silicon Valley should work with B's throughout the world to apply B2C stuff that Google and Facebook and Amazon and all these guys and Airbnb and Uber and all those guys can do for the rest of us. But we are 15 years away from equilibrium, I would guess. So by the way, which means B2B2C investments, by and large, the secular win by the secular these guys what these guys do for a living, they're a B helping other bees. Like, do you think of the AARP as like a leading edge, cutting edge? No, right? But are you going to help them?
We're on it.
You're on it. Okay, so B2B2C, really key. So what kind of applications? We call them systems of engagement. So the 90s was all about systems of record. We deployed systems of record throughout the entire globe. They were all database, transactional based. They were very hard to use, but they were very accurate, they were very reliable, and they went global. And they made global commerce possible. And they made China a world power. And they made India, gave it the potential to be a world power. I think India's kind of fumbled the future a bit. But still, both countries are massively better off, all because of systems of record deployed in the 90s. In the consumer thing, what happened was we created a fabric of engagement. And it wasn't used to support social outcomes. It wasn't used to support enterprise outcomes. It was used as essentially as a media phenomenon. It was a cultural change. We re-experienced life digitally. But what it did, because of the unbelievably innovative way in which this thing was deployed, it created the cloud fabric. It paved the way for the mobile fabric. And so now we have this opportunity to take systems of engagement and make them part of our, not only just part of our businesses, part of our healthcare system. So we can think about how much better healthcare is with a system of engagement, part of our education system, part of citizen services. So we have a part of the homeless people have smartphones, okay? You can deploy much better social services via that's another B2B2C. So I think the applications, they're all about communicating with constituents, creating optionality for constituents in situations, whether that's an educational situation, or a restaurant, or a flight. I mean, you know, we're very privileged in this room. We tend to, you know, want to make reservations.
And one of the things that where people are getting, finally, is we have entered a new era, the mobile era. And so what happens is a lot of the systems, IT systems that were good enough, are breaking. And so I'm going to give some kudos to my engineers, where we have built machine learning algorithms. But since we serve the marketer, it has to be accessible. So we can do dynamic machine learning that you turn on with a checkbox. And the lift is 600%. Not 6%. 600% at scale. So with a new era comes gross inequality for those who adopt versus those who don't.
Yeah, it's true. It's a huge pressure.